pagka kami nasa kotse, because I have this habit, focus driving, but when you talk to me, lalo na sa mga intersections, pinagtatawa ako dito na misis ko dyan in Labrad, that when you talk to me, as I was driving, at lalo na halimbawa magta-turn ako dito or sa kanan, but because I am talking, I'm out of focus, I always miss that turn. No, so it is a lesson for me. Oh, nga, no, because I was distracted. I lost focus on my direction. And it didn't just happen once, so many times. Lagi po akong ano. So it is a lesson for me to fix our eyes on the Lord. Sabi ni Paul kay Timothy, in the later times some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and to the doctrines of demons, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with hot iron. So ang warning dito ni Paul from the Holy Spirit to Timothy is be careful. You work hard. Huwag mong ikang i-neglect. Do not neglect. You see, kanina yung sa Proverbs, diba? Why were the thorns? Why were there nettles? Because that guy was negligent of his responsibility as a farmer. So Paul was encouraging Timothy to be a good servant of Jesus Christ, that if he instructs the brethren in these things, he will be a good minister of Jesus Christ, nourished in the words of faith and of the good doctrine, to reject profane fables and exercise himself toward godliness. Sabi ni Paul, for bodily exercise is profits a little, but godliness is profitable for all things, having the promise of the life that is now and of that which is to come. So what do? We keep on building on our faith. No, we already have that faith in the Lord. But we shouldn't stop there. Sabi ni Peter, kay Peter naman to. Basahin po natin. But also for this very reason, giving all faith diligence, and now add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self-control, to self-control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, and to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. So giving all due diligence, ang sabi dyan. So ibig sabihin maging giving all due diligence, ibig sabihin you are diligent, you are masinop, you are really working on it, no, walang masigasig. Thank you, sis. Masigasig, walang sinasayang na pagkakataon. Diligence is a study, steady, earnest and energetic effort, devoted and painstaking work and application to accomplish an undertaking. Sabi kanina, we have a work to do. We are called to go and bear fruit. We have a work to do after having given with this precious faith in God in our Lord Jesus Christ, for us to be growing spiritually and for us to bear fruit according to the working of God's will. So there is a progression in our faith. Na-discuss na po natin yan in January, so I'm not going to repeat those details of what virtue is. Alam na natin yan. Natatanda nyo ba itong slide na to? Last time in January? Okay po, so let's move. So my conditions to fruitfulness. This is a continuation of that verse. Sabi, for if these things are yours and abound, you will be neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. For he who lacks these things is short-sighted, even to blindness. So parang bulag. And has forgotten that he was cleansed from his old sins. Adding to our faith is actually activating our faith. Continue on this one. Nandiyan pa ba kayo?
Amen.
This is a continuation of those verses na hinati-hati ko lang po sa 3 slides. No, sabi kanina, add to your faith this, and then sabi ay kung sumasa inyo itong mga bagay na ito, sabi niya, you will neither be barren nor unfruitful. No. In the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Ibig sabihin, in your faith in the Lord, definitely you will have fruit if you have all this. And if you do not have this, I mean, you are short-sighted or even to blindness. And then it continues, and dito sa promise, the promise of an entrance to the kingdom. And sabi dyan, therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. And be diligent to make your call. Kanina dinisas natin yung call. Have we responded? Have we really responded to that call of the Lord? Have we responded to that call of the Lord? Sige nga po, tingnan ko lang kung sino yung mga tumugon. Tinugon mo na ba talaga yung pagtawag ng Panginoon? Mahina mo. Mahina, amen. Tinugon mo na ba talaga ang tawag ng Panginoon?
Amen.
Not all.
Amen. Amen po. Yes. Walang hangad na masama ang Diyos para sa atin. Lahat ay para sa kabutihan natin. Ang sabi dyan, therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. For so an entrance will be supplied to you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen po. So there's a warning. Sabi ni Peter again, basahin natin yan. You therefore, beloved, since you know this beforehand, beware lest you also fall from your own steadfastness, being led away with the error of the wicked. So there is a warning na posible tayong maled away ng error ng mga wicked. Kaya yung admonition ni Paul kanina sa Colossians, sabi niya, huwag na kayong mamuhay na katulad ng mga hintil. So ibig sabihin, there is really a danger. Hindi naman sinabing huwag ka na makisalamuha, ano? But we must be mindful. Our mind should be really fixed and focused on the Lord at yung sa tawag niya sa atin. Nakukuha po natin. So, there is a danger of not progressing and falling away. And sabi sa Hebrews 6:7, kung may Bible kayo dyan, hindi ko po sinulat sa slides. May danger ng if we don't progress and if we don't fall away. Sabi sa Hebrews 6:4-7, for it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted the heavenly gift and have become partakers of the Holy Spirit, and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the age to come. So ito 6, sabi, if they fall away, to renew them again to repentance, since they crucify again for themselves the Son of God and put Him to an open shame. For the earth which drinks in the rain that often comes upon it and bears herbs useful for those by whom it is cultivated, receives blessing from God. But if it bears thorns and briars, kapag ikatinik at mga briars ang lumabas, it is rejected and near to being cursed, whose end is to be burned. Sabi, it is impossible. Kapag naranasan mo na ang grace ng Panginoon, hindi ka na dapat lalayo sa Panginoon. Ang sabi niya, it is impossible for those who were once enlightened if you fall away, kung ikay tatalikod. Dahil, ano sabi? You are again, since they crucify again for themselves the Son of God. Muli mo ikang ipinapako si Kristo sa krus. And put Him to an open shame. So it's a personal responsibility sa atin that we keep our eyes and our minds focusing on the Lord. Ang sabi niya, if it bears thorns and briars, it is rejected and near to being cursed, whose end is to be burned. So what do we need to continue to do? Mga kapatid, praise God, because our Lord is always there for us. When we fall, Lord, help me, oh God. Lord, I have this struggle. Lord, help me, Lord. Make Christ our strength so that we don't fall away. Kanina sabi, allow the Holy Spirit, make the Holy Spirit, allow Him to move in you, in us, to fill us. Ang sabi dyan, but grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord Jesus and Savior Jesus Christ. So what do you need to do? Grow. Saan ka mag-grow? Keep on knowing who Jesus is. Seek Him. Know Him. Sabi kanina, the beauty, the excellence, His glory, His magnificence, God will show Himself to you. Sabi kanina, binasa ni Brother Vince, you will find me and search, no? And you will find me when you search for me with all your heart. Sa Jeremiah, binasa ni Brad kanina, God will reveal Himself to us. So we need to know Him for who He is. Amen po? Amen. So Peter concludes his letter by urging his readers to grow in the grace and knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to get to know Him better and better. No matter where we are in our spiritual journey, no matter how mature we are in the faith, the sinful world always challenges our faith. We all still have much room to grow. Lahat po tayo. Hindi natin sasabihin, narating ko na to, okay na ako dyan. No. That's the time that you start falling away. Nakuha niyo po natin. Nakuha po natin yun. Every day we must be diligent to draw closer to Christ. We will be constantly growing to maturity in bearing forth fruits of the faith. Amen po? Amen. Kanina na paulit-ulit nating nabasa yung about understanding, yung pagkaunawa, ano? The farmer who is devoid of understanding, what happens to his farm, nettles, matinik, you know? So it's a call for us to look into this. And sabi dyan, for this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you. And to ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him, being what? Being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. So, anong kailangan natin gawin? Pray. Make a habit. Minsan yung habits natin ang sumisira ng buhay natin. Especially if those are bad habits. So this is the time that we look, how do I use my time? How do I use my mind? Where do I focus on? So instead of moving in these things, no, wasting time, and sabi niya, pray. Sabi niya sa Bible, pray without? So sabi niya, non-stop praying. Hindi ilalagay sa Bible kung hindi yun importante. Hindi yun ilalagay kung hindi, sabi, pray without ceasing. Why? Because the enemy, this world, the devil, is God, is relentless. Walang patid yan. So we need to pray. And sabi, be filled. Be that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will. How do we be filled with knowledge? Anong kailangan mong gawin para ma-fill ka ng knowledge? Read the Bible, we need to study. Kagabi na-discuss din namin, yung personal growth, yung spiritual growth mo is a personal responsibility. You cannot just rely on the pastor every Sunday. It's your personal relationship with the Lord. So, I pray that from now on this time,